What's up, everybody? Your boy Jumpman back on Sunday, August the 21st, 2011. I did some changing around in the basement of the J's. I found some things that I want to share with you throughout the next couple of days and weeks. And also, I'm going to do a review of the Cardinal 7. I know people have already done them, but I just wanted to do my own and just see if there's anything different that I saw that other people may not have seen. Let's jump off into it. All right. Here we go. The 2006, 2011. The first thing that's noticeable are the gold tips on the laces. They're chrome tips on the 2011s. The tumbled leather and smooth leather here on the 2006 and 2011. Not much different, except the 2011, if you notice, are a little more shinier than the 2006. Going to the front of the shoe, looking at the tongue and the sock liner, a little darker of the red bronze on the 2006 compared to the 2011. Looking at the sides of the shoe, still the same color patterns, the same holes for perforation and breathability, and the same Jumpman. Although the 2011 is a little bit slimmer than the 2006. MJ lost a little weight. The inside of the shoe, you can see on the tongue, made in China. Made in China, just a little different pattern, but still the same thing. Black interior or insole with a red Jumpman on both of them. Your pull tab in the back. And you can see the outline on the 2006 is in red and then black with the white 23. And on the 2011 is black and then that cardinal color, which is a little bit darker, if you can tell. On the 7, that is a 7 there with the 23. And here on the right shoe, the 7 is backwards. Same hint of black around the Jumpman there, just on the outside of the sock liner. The outsole are the same. So we're going to get ready to take them straight to the foot game. I'm going to do one of each so you can see. We'll do the 2006 on the right, on the left, and the 2011 on the right, and you can tell by, of course, the tips. Both are size 13. And you can see the shirt that I'm sporting here. What it says there. And as I was looking through some things, I came across some older stuff that I have. This is kind of interesting, from 1996. Look at these Concords that are coming back out, and you see that blue bottom on them that's going to be coming out on the 2011s. And this is from 1996, you know, when they wore the alternative uniforms with the pinstripe jerseys, and MJ sporting my favorite shoes of all time, the 8s, 3 in a row. The Bulls beat the Suns 4-2 in 1993. MJ busting a J against Dan Marley. And these are just some other pictures I came across. This was a picture that someone painted for me. And it's 556 out of 1,000. He made 1,000 of them. And this is old school stuff I picked up for 25 cents. And look at the shoes MJ is wearing. The tubes. I picked up quite a few of them. The Baby Dream Team right there. Space Jam stuff. Some more Space Jam stuff here. MJ and Bugs. MJ rocking the 4s. You can see that Nike Air back there on the back. And these are some posters with Spike Lee, MJ in the 3s. You see that Nike Air back there on the 5s. These are all calendars, 1993, 1994. It has just pictures on the back. Just things like that. And then I switched it around a little bit. This is a picture that Brendan drew freehand for me a while ago. Some other things I have. The Wheaties boxes. The Dream Team, Triple Play from Space Jam. And then this is, we all know what this is here. The shot that won championship number 6. Then here's the cards that I have. I'll get to these another day and go through them. Those are all the MJ cards. And just to show you around again, starting over there with the shoes and working our way around the laptop bags. Still have a few of the shirts left in the Captain Rock. People have been buying them. I appreciate you for that. One of the 2 games I went to see MJ when he's with the Wizards. That's the only time I got to see him when he's with the Wizards. I didn't get to see him when he was with the Bulls. And we end up right here. All right, this your boy Jumpman. I'll holler at you. Peace.